Hi, this is Anne with Graphic Design How To, and today I'm going to show you how to create a stipple grain texture brush for shading in Adobe Illustrator. All right, let's get started. Okay, so if you're wondering what I mean by stipple texture, I'm talking about the type of texture that's shown in these images, like here on the hat, this kind of stipple shading. You can see it here on the ball. So we're going to learn how to create a brush that will do this. All right, let's go to Illustrator. And I'll come over here to create new. I'll choose print up here at the top and then choose letter here and then we'll create. And now I want my texture to be somewhat small, so I'm just going to zoom into the upper left corner. And now I'm going to draw some little random shapes. I'm just going to create four. I'll hit N on my keyboard and I'll just draw the first one. And I didn't get it all the way closed, so I'm going to hit Command J to close it. And then I'll just kind of smooth it out. It's almost a circle. So the next one I'm going to have a little bit longer like this. We'll join that one also. And I'm going to smooth this out. I'm toggling to the smooth tool by holding Option or Alt on a PC. That'll get you to the smooth tool right over here. When you're on the pencil tool, the N tool, you can hold Option and just smooth things out. Okay, so I've got my four little shapes. And I'm just going to hit D on my keyboard to get a white fill and a black outline. And then I'll switch those with Shift X. I'll click on my white and then just get rid of that by hitting the question mark and backslash key. And now I'm going to create a new layer. So I'll click on my layers panel. If you don't see some of these panels, you can get to those under window. So window layers is right here. And now I'm going to create a new layer. I'll pull this one underneath the other layer, and then I'll click on that layer, and I'm going to hit L to get on my circle tool, and I'll just hold Shift and draw a circle. I want this to be a stroke only, so I'm going to hit Shift X to get just a stroke. I'm going to put my stroke at 0.5, and by the way, if you're not seeing this up here, that is right here, window control. And of course, you can also get to your stroke in your window too. Okay, so we've got our circle on layer two, and I'm just going to lock that. Now I'll get back on layer one, and my goal here is to copy these shapes until they fill up the circle. I might want it to be a little bit smaller. So I'm holding Option or Alt to make a copy, and then I'll just move these around and try to randomize them a little bit. It can be a little hard to do that. I think that's one of the harder things to do as a designer is trying to make a random pattern. And I'll speed up the video so you don't have to sit through all this, but basically I want them all the way out to the edge. Now to get a little more rotation in there, I'm hitting Shift, Option, Command, D. That's Shift, Alt, Control, D on a PC, and changing my angle. And this will change the angle of each piece, not the whole thing together, so that's kind of nice. Now I'm going to delete layer two. And this is pretty good. This is looking about like what I'm hoping for. I think I'll select all the pieces and just move them over a little bit. And now I'm going to take some of the pieces from the middle and put them kind of out on the edge a little bit. So we'll just do that. I'm looking for areas that are kind of a little crowded, maybe like this. These pieces out here help to give it kind of a more random look. Okay, now I'm going to select everything and I'll open my brushes panel, window brushes, and I'm just going to click and drag this into my brush panel. We want a new scatter brush, so I'll say okay, and then we'll get this dialog box. Now we want to randomize our spacing and our rotation, so I'm going to change both of those to random. I'm going to set our minimum spacing at 15 and our maximum at 25. And then for rotation, I'll set the minimum at minus 145 and positive 145. And then for the method, I want to choose tints. This will allow us to choose a color with the brush, otherwise it'll kind of be stuck at black. Okay, so we'll say okay. And you can see our little brush right up here. Now I'm going to draw a circle, so I'll hit L on my keyboard to get to my circle tool. I'll click and drag and hold Shift, and I'm just going to change this to blue. And then I'm going to make a copy of this and paste in front with Command F or Control F. So I have two blue circles right on top of each other. And now I'm going to choose Draw Inside, which is this third little button at the bottom of your toolbar. So when we do this, it'll give us these kind of dotted lines outside our shape, and that means it's a Draw Inside object. So I want to choose our brush. Then I'm going to double click on my stroke color. We'll make this quite a bit darker and say OK. And now I'll hit N on my keyboard to get to my pencil tool. I'm just going to draw right along here to give it kind of a shaded look. As you can see, it is really big. So there are two things we can do. We can reduce the size of our stroke to about 0.25 or 0.3 until we get the look we want. Instead of doing that, I like to just resize the brush itself so that I don't always have to change it. So I'm going to hit S to get to my scale tool and then enter return to get to the options. So I'm going to scale this by 33%. We'll say OK. And now I'm just going to drag this into my brush panel and hold option to replace this brush. We'll say OK. And then it'll ask us, do we want to apply it to the strokes we've already made? We'll say apply. And it'll change this one to 1/3 of what it is, roughly. So now we can put this at 1 point, and it should be a little more what we're looking for. I'm going to zoom in on this and we can see how this looks. Now before we get too much further, we want to save our brush. So I'm going to get over here on the side. So first I'm going to go to my brushes and just select all the unused ones and just delete those. So we'll be left with our basic brushes and our new brush. And now I'm going to come over to the flyout and choose Save Brush Library. And I'll just save this as stipple. If we close this document and we open a new document, we don't lose our stipple brush. We can load it by coming right over here and going to Open Brush Library, User Defined, and here it is, stipple. So what if you want to add a stipple brush across multiple shapes? With a draw inside object, you can only do that with one shape at a time. So I'll show you how to do this with a bird that I downloaded from Vectizi. I'm opening my bird. I'm just going to copy and paste him into my document. And he's coming in into the paste inside object. So I'm going to undo and I'll get back on my regular draw normal mode. Now I'll paste my bird in again. And I think I want the shading to come right down here along the underside of his belly. So to do that, I can't draw inside on each of these shapes. That would just take too long. So I'm going to make a copy. I'll paste in front with Command F or Control F. And then I'm just going to Pathfinder Unite this. So I've got my Pathfinder window right over here, and I'll do the first shape mode, which is Unite. It'll change the whole thing to one of the colors, which is fine. I'm just going to click on the fill and get rid of it with my question mark or backslash key. So now I have a no fill and no stroke shape in the shape of the bird. Now I'm going to draw inside this shape. So I'm going to click that, and I'll get on my stipple brush. And my stipple brush right now is orange, so I want to change that. I'll just choose black. Then I'll hit N to get on my pencil tool. I'm going to start right up here and just draw around his belly like this. I'll zoom in a little bit and I'll just adjust this a little. This should be rounded a little more. I can also smooth this brush out by holding Option or Alt while on my pencil tool to get to my smooth tool. So we have our shading now. I think I'm going to increase this to 1.5 or 1.3. Okay, that looks good. I want these dots on the orange part of the beak to be kind of a darker orange. I want these parts to be blue. So we can use Multiply to do this. So in my Appearance panel, I can click on my opacity and change that to 40 or so. And then I can change normal to multiply. And when we zoom in, you can see it's just a darker orange. It matches what colors underneath it a little better. Okay, and because we made this in the way we did, if we pull this over, we have the shading separate from the colors here. So I'm going to undo that. I'm going to go back to draw normal. And then I'm going to select everything and just group it with Command G or Control G. So that's how to create and use a stipple brush for shading. All right, if you like this video and you want to see more videos like this, just hit the subscribe button and the little bell next to it and you'll be notified every time a new video comes out. All right, I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.